Today I'm gonna test out Aqua Resin, Cementol, Hydrocal, Jesmonite, and my own formula of cement, plaster, and sand. I'll add some color to the mixture for pizzazz. Special shout out to Glow Marble for gifting Up Vibe the colors that will be added to three of the mixtures today. I will pour my mixture into this Amazon silicone mold. All the links are in the description. Then, when we're done, I'm going to compare them and see which one's the best. Oh, and stick around till the end because I'm gonna share with you which one's my favorite. Let's go. Aqua Resin. Hi, my name is Jay Catalano. Aqua Resin has a 3-to-1 mixture ratio, so I'm adding 225 grams of S3 powder component and 75 grams of L liquid component for a total of 300 grams. Then I'm going to mix them together thoroughly until I reach a smoothie-like consistency. Once complete, I'm going to add in a few drops of blue pigment and stir that together. Notice how it starts to form a marble effect. If I wanted to achieve that effect, I would stop stirring and pour now. However, I want a solid blue, so I'll keep stirring. Now I'm going to add in my mixture to my vibrating machine. Once it gets to the top, I'll let it harden to the point where I can demold it. After an hour and a half, I'm ready to demold and present to you my Aqua Resin candle vessel. And here is my blue colored Aqua Resin vessel made with an Aqua Resin kit I purchased from, you guessed it, aquaresin.com. The kit came with 4 different colors and I chose blue for this particular candle jar because I love the color blue. The kit cost me $37.50. Which is expensive considering the size, but it's an awesome product. And if I would have bought a larger container of Aqua Resin, my cost would have come down considerably. The demolded weight of the vessel weighed in at 287 grams, and 3 days later, it weighed 283 grams, which is a 4-gram weight difference. I really like that adding my mixture together was super easy as I had never really used Aqua Resin before. It was also very easy to demold my vessel after an hour and a half, and because I didn't have much leftover waste, cleanup was as easy as wiping it away. Let's move on. Cementol. Cementol has a 4-to-1 ratio, so I'm adding 280 grams of cementol along with 5% of 14 grams of green pigment to my mixture. I'm mixing them together thoroughly before adding 70 grams of water. Once added, I'm going to stir that together until there are no lumps or clumps so I can achieve a smoothie-like consistency. Then, I'm going to add my green cementol mixture to my vibrating machine until it gets to the top, and then I'll let it sit for 3 hours before demolding it. After 3 hours, I'm ready to demold and present to you my cementol candle vessel. And here is my green cementol concrete vessel. I purchased a 55-pound bag of cementol from my local Home Depot for $27.69. I added willow green to color my candle jar, which was one of the colors that was generously gifted to me from Globe Marble. Links to their amazing pigments, and I mean amazing, in the description. The demolded weight of the vessel weighed in at 314 grams, and 3 days later, it weighed 291 grams, which is a 23 gram weight difference. Demolding cementol vessels is easy after 3 hours, and cleanup is extremely easy for me. I let the remaining contents harden, crack them off in my mixing bowl, and throw away the rest. Doesn't get any easier than that. Done. Let's move on. Hydrocal. Hydrocal has approximately a 1 to 2.5 ratio. I'm adding in 250 grams of hydrocal and 5% or 12 grams of orange to my mixture. Then I'm going to mix that together thoroughly and put that to the side. Now I'm going to bring another mixing bowl of 100 grams of water to the center and slowly add my hydrocal orange mixture to the water. The idea is that my added mixture must start to develop a dry lake bed effect before mixing it all together. Once it's ready, I'm going to stir that together thoroughly and add that to my Amazon silicone mold already on top of my vibrating machine. Once it reaches the top, I'll let it dry for 1 hour before demolding it. After an hour, I'm ready to demold and present to you my Hydrocal candle vessel. And here is my orange Hydrocal candle jar. I purchased a 50-pound bag of Hydrocal from Euclids.com for $69.68. I added orange buff to color my candle jar, which was one of the other colors that was generously gifted to me from Globe Marble. The demolded weight of the vessel weighed in at 285 grams, And 3 days later, it weighed 249 grams, which is a 36 gram weight difference.
Whoa!
Demolding Hydrocal vessels is very easy after 1 hour, and cleanup is similar to my cementol process. I just let the remaining contents harden, crack them off in my mixing bowl, and throw away the rest. Bam, let's move on. Jay's formula.
My formula has approximately a 2:1:1:1 ratio. I'm mixing 150 grams of sand, 75 grams of cement, and 75 grams of plaster together thoroughly. Then I'll add and thoroughly mix 5% or 15 grams of red pigment into the mixture. Then I'll add 75 grams of water and mix that together thoroughly as well. Once I'm satisfied that it's mixed thoroughly together, I'll add that to my Amazon silicone mold already on top of my vibrating machine. Once it reaches the top, I let it dry for 3 hours before demolding it. After 3 hours, I'm ready to demold and present to you my red concrete candle vessel.
And here is my red concrete candle jar using my personal formula. A formula designed for those who don't have access to any of the products I'm using in this video today. I purchased a 50-pound bag of sand, cement, and plaster from my local Home Depot store for a total of $45.72. I added the red to color my candle jar, which was the third color that was gifted to me from Globe Marble. Again, links are in the description. Thanks, Globe Marble. The demolded weight of the vessel weighed in at 314 grams, and 3 days later, it weighed 278 grams, which, like the Hydrocal, is a 36 gram weight difference. Demolding these vessels using my formula is very easy between the 1 and 3 hour mark, depending on the products you use. Cleaning up is similar to cleaning up my cementol and Hydrocal vessel. In case you forgot, let it harden, crack it off, throw it away. Bam, let's move on. Jesmonite.
Jesmonite has a 2.5:1 ratio. I'm adding 225 grams of powder base to 90 grams of liquid. Once combined, I'm going to stir it thoroughly until I reach a smoothie-like consistency. Then I'm going to add 15 drops of yellow pigment and stir that thoroughly until it's completely yellow throughout the mixture. Then I'm going to add my mixture to my Amazon silicone mold, which is already on the vibrating machine, and wait until it reaches the top. Once it's finished, I let it harden for 1.5 hours so I can demold and present to you my yellow Jesmonite candle vessel.
And here is my yellow Jesmonite candle vessel. I purchased a starter kit from madmaker.com for $53. The kit came with 5 different colors and I chose yellow for this particular candle jar. Jesmonite isn't easy to come by in the United States and isn't necessarily cost effective for me, but it's an awesome product. The demolded weight of the vessel weighed in at 289 grams, and 3 days later, it weighed 285 grams, which is a 4 gram weight difference. Also, demolding Jesmonite vessels is very easy after 1.5 hours, and cleanup was as easy as wipe, 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 throw it away. Now, let's find out which is the best and my overall favorite. All right, here we are with all 5 candle vessels. We have Aqua Resin, Cementol, Hydrocal, Jay's Formula, and Jesmonite. Each and every one of them is awesome in their own way. And I'm not just saying that, I truly mean it. And to be honest, each and every one of them are pretty similar to the other. Which one is the best? Well, although that's subjective, let's take an objective look at the situation, leaving the purchasing cost factor out of the equation. Although each of them are very similar, there is one that really seems to be the best for multiple purposes. And I'm sure, after you hear me out, most of you would agree, or at least I think you will. And that is the Hydrocal vessel. I can just see the Aqua Resin, Cementol, and Jesmonite viewers like this right now. Hear me out. Here's why. Number one, Hydrocal has a very long working time. If you add Hydrocal to the water and don't mix it, you can leave the contents as they are for a very, very long time. In fact, the longer you leave to absorb the water, the easier it is to use, which will help to achieve a very smooth and flowing mixture. This is very convenient if you're multitasking like I always do. Number two, you can demold the Hydrocal vessel in as little as 30 minutes. That is a very fast and significant amount of time to save if you are making hundreds of vessels at a time. To put that in financial perspective,
I would have to buy 6 Amazon silicone molds to demold 6 vessels in 3 hours if I were creating vessels using Cementol. Or I can buy 1 Amazon silicone mold and demold 6 vessels in 3 hours. That is a big savings. Number 3, have you seen bubbles in your vessels before? Of course you have. Well, Hydrocal seemed to have had the least amount of bubbles, with Aqua Resin coming in a close second. I personally don't mind bubbles, but if you do, Hydrocal seem to be the best. Number 4, Hydrocal along with Jesmonite and Aqua Resin weighed about the same immediately after demolding the vessel. However, Hydrocal really dropped weight after 3 days and was the clear winner, weighing in at a very light weight of 249 grams. To put that in financial perspective, there was a differential of 51 grams between Cementol and Hydrocal. We know that there are 454 grams in a pound. So if I ship 9 Hydrocal vessels or 9 Cementol vessels, my Cementol shipment will weigh 1 pound more than my Hydrocal shipment. And according to the US Post Office, for packages heavier than 1 pound, there is typically a 25 cent increase for each additional pound. 25 cents might not seem like a lot, but if you are shipping 90 or more vessels a week, you can save $130 a year. Remember what your mom told you, pennies make the dollar. I don't know, maybe your mom didn't tell you that. My mom told me that all the time. And now, which is my favorite? Well, I can't deny it, even though I use Cementol as my main source for making concrete vessels, Hydrocal is my favorite. And take a look at these videos that are popping up now. They're gonna help you on your concrete candle making journey. Until next time, thanks for watching. Ciao.